Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Today's discussion focuses on kind of a looking under the hood of the 2170 battery. So I recruited a good buddy of mine who is a PhD from MIT to sort of look a little bit at the battery chemistry of the new 2170. And there are a few points that I think are worth noting. Bonjour, wie geht's? Stets noch immer aus zwei Beinen. Strasvice, ni hao ma. So, the 2170 is sort of the new baby that every Tesla vehicle will be based on over the next few years. As I spent some time reviewing sort of the chemistry of what was done with it, a few points came up that I thought were kind of interesting that I didn't know. And I have to admit, my grade in chemistry wasn't that great, so you can't crucify me on this one. The first item I was taught about is the fact that unlike a regular consumer battery, the lithium ion batteries, on the inside, there are a number of cells that are in there, and those cells are separated from each other. So when the battery is charged, if it's a slow charge, each of those cells may or may not be charged on each usage or charging session of that battery, and it's being expended. A second pointer was that one of the ways they were able to achieve what they did with the new battery is if you have two separate batteries, as it was the case with the old battery, what you could actually do is remove the jacket from both batteries and put two batteries together in one jacket. So now you have more power in the battery, but you also don't take up, you take up less space, but more importantly, you can also remove weight because you're using one jacket rather than two. So this allows you to increase density, and the density increase is one way you can lower weight, lower cost, and it looks like this is one of the methods that it was likely used on the new battery. I also thought sort of learning more about the battery chemistry brought up some questions regarding supercharging and super discharging. So when you go to ludicrous mode on the vehicle, you're asking all those cells to discharge at one time. And this routine activity can cause damage to those cells. And I'm told that the degradation of the cells actually increases when you use the supercharger a lot as well. So there's a limited number of circles you can go on of charge recharge. And evidently supercharging or super discharging of those cells can affect how many of those cells suddenly become dead. And when you end up charging after a while, you end up running out of, after a certain percentage, the battery stops charging. I'm intrigued because Tesla hasn't made any effort to describe sort of the long-term impact of the usage of heavy amounts of supercharger, but I think this will be interesting to see on the Tesla forums what those who've been doing this a lot have to say. I was kind of surprised because I guess the biggest surprise I picked up on this was the fact that this really is a new battery. In the case of the old battery, Tesla consistently sort of modified the configuration of 81650, which had been in use in laptops for a long time. And given that this is a new battery, I'm wondering about things like, as it goes on the road, might we see sort of early stage issues relative to overheating, etc., because, you know, it is a new battery, a new construct, and may have a break-in period. I also thought this dialogue was useful because taking some time to understand what's going on in the battery pack of the vehicle might give you a window on other things that you might want to address. As you know, the high temperatures or low temperatures can also affect the chemical reaction or the movement of those electrons in and out of the vehicle. So I really think that over time, I will definitely jump back into battery chemistry and the movement of electrons and the impact of heat and cold on those electrons, because frankly, it really sucks when you jump in your car and the temperature goes below freezing and you now have the problem of half the battery life you thought you had, including things like you lose 7% of your, or 7 miles of battery range on a daily basis in cold temperatures as well without moving the vehicle. Thank you once again for taking time out to listen to our chat. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Tschüss, mach's gut, au revoir, à tout à l'heure, Lihitraut, Khoda Hafez. And please like and subscribe.